Hey guys, what's up? How's it going? I hope you're having a great day. My name is Hardit, and today we'll be taking a look at the glyphs for druids in the new expansion for World of Warcraft called Warlords of Draenor. Now, the first major glyph that comes to mind is called the Glyph of Astral Communion, and it's a balanced glyph that says that your Astral Communion ability can be used while moving. Obviously, this ability was changed a little bit, the Astral Communion, because now it just accelerates its cycle by 300% for 4 seconds. Remember that the eclipse cycle bar just automatically changes by itself, so what Astral Communion does is actually make it quicker, as you see like in the eclipse bar. So all this does is lets you cast Astral Communion while moving. So the next glyph coming up is called the Glyph of Barkskin. The Glyph of Barkskin itself, it says that it reduces the chance you'll be critically hit by 25% while Barkskin is active. It's a pretty solid glyph, and it just allows you to be crit immune, mostly crit immune, because taking off 25% chance is pretty huge. Now the next glyph available, it's called the Glyph of Celestial Alignment. It's a major glyph and it's for balance. And it says the Celestial Alignment now lasts for 60 seconds or until 8 spells have been cast with it active, whichever occurs first. I really like this glyph for balance druids, just because of the fact that you don't have to worry about being CC'd while this cooldown is up. And you can get most of the needed spells out of this rotation. I mean, 8 spells is a pretty big amount of spells instead of just using the regular amount of time that Celestial Alignment is up. So I highly recommend it if you're playing PvP. So the next glyph is called Glyph of Cyclone. It's a major glyph and it says it increases the range of your Cyclone spell by 5 yards. Now, obviously this glyph is really good for classes that have to cast Cyclone. Obviously Cyclone, it has to be cast by Ferals, but I believe that Ferals don't really need this glyph as they have a lot more possibilities to take. So the next glyph is called Glyph of Dash. It's a major glyph and it says that it reduces the cooldown of your dash ability by 60 seconds. Pretty solid glyph and pretty basic. The next glyph is called Glyph of Entangling Energy. It's for balance druids and it's a major glyph. When you kill an enemy that yields experience or honor, your next Starfire or Wrath also applies entangling roots to your target. Now this glyph is really useful for killing mobs and grinding mobs in general. You can just Wrath and Starfire them and they will be rooted and you'll be able to apply more damage to them without being able to be hit. Like I said, it's really good for leveling, maybe even good for... No, only good for leveling. So the next glyph coming up is called Glyph of Entangling Roots. This is a major glyph and reduces the cast time of your Entangling Roots by 0.2 seconds. Obviously makes the ability faster and allows you to just cast it faster if you need, if you're worried about interrupts, for example. The next glyph coming up is called the Glyph of Fairy Fire. It's a major glyph and it increases the range of your Fairy Fire by 10 yards. Pretty solid glyph. I don't believe many people use it anymore, but it's really useful for some scenarios. The next glyph is called Glyph of Guided Stars. It's a balance glyph, and it's a major glyph that says that your Starfall and Sunfall only hit targets affected by your Moonfire or Sunfire. Obviously, you want to watch out when you pop, for example, Starfall without the glyph, but with this glyph, you don't have to worry, and the Starfall will only affect the targets that are dotted. Now, Healing Touch is a balance and restoration glyph, and it's a major glyph that says that when you cast Healing Touch, the cooldown on your Nature Swiftness is reduced by 3 seconds. I don't believe many people have used this glyph in the past. Maybe they have, actually, in PvE, but it's just a glyph that is just there and useful to have if you can just cast Healing Touches, I guess. Now the next glyph is called Glyph of Hurricane. It's a balanced glyph and says that your Hurricane and Astral Storm abilities now also slow the movement speed of their victims by 50%. This is actually good for AoE situations in PvE, just because of the fact that if a Nova breaks, for example, they'll still be slowed by 50% and they'll still take some of the damage if people are casting AoEs there. So the next glyph is called Glyph of Imbued Barkskin, and says that while Barkskin is active, when you are interrupted, the resulting school lock has a 50% reduced duration. This is actually a pretty nice glyph and allows you to just cast through interrupts and, I mean, if you get interrupted, it only has a 50% reduced duration. Then we have Glyph of Master Shapeshifter. It's a major glyph and reduces the mana cost of all shapeshifts by 100%. I don't believe many people use this, but in case you're worried about your mana while shapeshifting, there you go. Then we have Glyph of Might of Orzhog. It's a major glyph and it increases the health gain from Might of Orzhog by 20%, but increases the cooldown for by 2 minutes. This glyph is also obviously made to have a bigger cooldown than the regular Might of Orzhog one, and it just increases the cooldown by 2 minutes. It's sort of like a trade-off. Then we have the Glyph of Moon Ward. It's a balance glyph and it's a major glyph that says that Moonkin Form no longer grants bonus armor, but instead grants 10% increased maximum health. I guess that this glyph can be used against spellcasters just because of the fact that armor doesn't matter when you're fighting spell cleaves. But it's just personal preference, I guess, and very situational. Then we have Glyph of Nature's Grasp. I believe that Nature's Grasp was taken out of the game, yes, as you see. So this glyph is kind of obsolete and hasn't been taken out of the spellbook. Then we have Glyph of Rake. And it says that it's a major glyph and increases the range of your rake by 8 yards while Prowl is active. Alright, it just gives you a longer range to use rake. Pretty interesting, maybe for people with higher MS so they can get their rake off. Then we have Glyph of Rebirth. Glyph of Rebirth is a major glyph and players resurrected by Rebirth are returned to life with 100% health. Pretty decent glyph, and if there's constant AoE going on or constant damage, this glyph can be obviously really useful. Then we have Glyph of Shapemender. It's a balance and restoration glyph and a major glyph obviously, and it says that each time you activate shapeshift form, you are healed by 4-5% of your maximum health. This effect cannot occur more than once in every 5 seconds. It's just like a small heal, like I said before, it's similar to Ysera's gift. And every time you switch forms, obviously if you keep track of time, it could be pretty useful and effective. But very situational, again, depending on what comps you face. Now we have Glyph of Stampeding Roar, and it increases the radius of Stampeding Roar by 30 yards. And you can now cast Stampeding Roar without being in Bear or Cat form. Pretty useful if you don't want to keep shapeshifting out of forms and wasting global cooldowns. You just have to glyph and you just get an instant sprint. Now there's a glyph called Glyph of Sudden Eclipse. It's a balance glyph and major glyph that says, while not in an eclipse state, critical attacks done to you restore 20 solar or lunar energy, whichever is more beneficial to you, and this effect can only occur once in 20 seconds. Pretty decent glyph, even though that I think that the eclipse part runs fine by itself, so I don't think that the Glyph of Sudden Eclipse will be really needed. Now we have the Glyph of Survival Instincts. That's a major glyph, and it reduces the cooldown of Survival Instincts by 40 seconds, but reduces the duration by 50%. Now obviously if you're worried about a quick burst that the enemy can do to you, you can just use the Glyph of Survival Instincts, and you will have the cooldown a lot sooner. Obviously remember that Moonkins have 2 charges for it, so it's obviously like a trade-off if you think that the burst opportunity is a lot smaller than you really need the 12 seconds for. Now we have Glyph of Ursul's Defense. It's a balanced feral and restoration that says that increases your armor in Barrowform by an additional 210%. So if you're getting trained by melee, I would have to test this glyph out, but it could be beneficial if your armor is increased by 210%. Could be a lot of damage mitigation. Now we have a restoration glyph, which is a major called Glyph of Blooming. Increases the bloom heal of your life bloom when it expires by 50%, but its duration is reduced by 5 seconds, and your healing touch, nourish, and regrowth abilities no longer refresh the duration. Okay, pretty solid restoration glyph. Then we have the Glyph of Cat Form, which is a feral glyph and a major glyph that says that increases your healing done to you by 20% in cat form. This is pretty much, I think that every feral is going to be taking this on threes, for example, or when they run with a healer, because 20% increased healing is quite a lot. Then we have Glyph of Enchanted Bark for restoration that it says that for 5 seconds after activating bark skin, you are immune to silence and interrupt effects. Really, really good glyph, and I would definitely take it as restoration just because of the fact that it gives you silence immunity, and that's amazing. Now we have Glyph of Face Silence. This is that glyph of the Fairy Fire used in bear form, but silences the target for 3 seconds. And it also has a 15 second cooldown every trigger. Pretty decent glyph, and it could be used as an interrupt, I guess, for Guardian. Then we have Glyph of Ferocious Bite. And your Ferocious Bite ability heals you for 1.5 of your maximum health for each 10 energy used. Wow, so it's actually pretty nice. Pretty nice heal if you're soloing, for example, and you want some self-healing. There you go. Now we have Glyph of Mame, which is a major glyph, and it increases the damage done by Mame by 100%. Mame doesn't do more, like, a lot of damage by itself, so I don't know exactly if this is an incredible glyph for Feral Druids. Maybe some Feral Druids can chime in the comments, so let me know if this glyph is worth it. Then we have Glyph of Maul, that says that your Maul ability now hits one additional target for 50% damage. Obviously, it helps you generate more threat on AoE targets, or multiple targets, since it's a Guardian Glyph. Now there's a glyph called Glyph of the Ninth Life. It's a Feral Glyph, and it says it reduces all damage taken while in cat form by 10%. I guess it's a solid damage reduction glyph. I don't think many people will take it because you already have the 20% heal increase, but who knows. Then we have the Glyph of Restoration, which is a major glyph, and it increases the critical strike chance of your regrowth by 40%, but no longer does any healing over time. It's a pretty solid glyph that was taken a lot in Mists of Pandaria. So maybe a lot of Restoroots will take it. It is pretty solid to have an instant or like almost guaranteed critical heal available. And remember that regrowth doesn't have much cast time, so it could be a pretty important heal. Now we have Glyph of Rejuvenation, and it says that when you have Rejuvenation active on 3 or more targets, the cast time of your Healing Touch spell is reduced by 10%. It's mostly a PvE glyph and will not have much use in PvP, but obviously if it's reduced by 10%, I guess Healing Touch could be worth casting. Then we have Glyph of Savage Roar, which is a Feral glyph, and it says that when you rake or shred while prowling, you're granted Savage Roar as if it was used with 5 combo points. Pretty solid for openers, I really like it, and a lot of Feral Druids friend of mine are taking it, so it must be worth it. Then we have Glyph of Skullbash, which is a Feral and Guardian talent that increases the duration of your Skullbash intro by 2 seconds, but increases the cooldown by 5 seconds. Pretty solid trade-off. And the last glyph, called Glyph of Wild Growth. It's a restoration glyph, and it says that Wild Growth can affect one additional target, but its cooldown is increased by 2 seconds. Now we can see all the minor glyphs right now, and I do believe that these glyphs have not changed. I believe that the glyph of this stack is the only glyph that's new. And the glyph of Chameleon looks pretty interesting. I'm actually gonna try this out because it could be we'll have a random hair color. All right, so let's see. So my hair is red, then it's green, then it's red, then it's green. Not many. Oh, there's blue. Could be like a fun little talent to play with. And we have Glyph of the Stack that says that your stack form can now be used as a mount by party members. This is already a, like, unknown glyph. And this is a glyph. This is also a new glyph. Glyph of the Sprouting Mushroom. Your mushroom. Actually, it's not new. It's not new. I lied. But yeah, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed the glyphs overview for restoration. For druids in the Worlds of Generic expansion. I like them so far. I really like the fact that Barskin was added back in the game. Druids needed a little bit more cooldowns. And I really enjoyed the fact that some glyphs are really interesting. Anyways, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to like it up and share if you enjoyed it and thought it was useful. And I'll see you guys later. Don't forget to check out any other class glyphs on the page behind or the initial intro. Or, you know, check out my channel. See you guys later.